quick caveat at this point. So you may have noticed that the apostrophe is in a different place in ones versus twos complement. That's not immediately apparent when you're speaking the names of the representations, but it is apparent when you write them down. There is actually a meaning to this. So in ones complement, we take the value and the unsigned integer value, and we, in order to negate it, we take the complement with respect to all ones. So this is multiple ones, which means in English you form sort of the possessive by adding the apostrophe at the end after the S. When you do this in twos complement, you're actually sort of doing a complement with respect to a power of two, which is why there's only one two, one power of two, and so that's why we generally refer to this as twos complement with the apostrophe before the S. Not a super important detail, but one that I felt was worth mentioning. Another thing that I would like to highlight at this point is that a lot of students tend to get complement with an E mixed up with complement with an I. So in English, the complement with an E is, you know, something that complements. So it's something that kind of goes with something else, or that helps to kind of complete it, or is sort of the other side of the same coin. And then complement with an I is, you know, saying something nice about something. And so I like to tell my students, you know, we're not complimenting the one or the two. We're not telling the two that it's a particularly nice number. We are using it as an operation. So another technicality here that you may run into if you're looking for materials and supplementary help online is that ones complement and twos complement are sort of both an encoding and an operation. So people will sometimes talk about performing twos complement versus the number is stored in twos complement. And this is a slightly confusing. The thing that links the two is that the operation, so the twos complement operation, represents the action necessary to negate a number in twos complement. So that's the relationship between the two. One way to summarize this is, you know, if you have a value that you know is in a particular encoding, if the sign bit is not set, then it's a positive number. If the sign bit is set, it's a negative number. In order to recover the positive value, then you do the operation, and that will negate it. This is slightly confusing, however, and so in this course, we will be avoiding using the operation terminology. So I'm going to avoid telling you to perform twos complement. We're just going to reserve that terminology to refer to the encoding. So I will say this number is in twos complement, negate it. And then you will know to use the operation that we talked about, where you flip all the ones and add zero to do the negation, because the number is in twos complement. So make sure that this does not, try not to let this trip you up.